Goedemorgen, everybody. I hope you all had a wonderful Shabbos. Welcome to the Daily Dose of Pilsen and Mishnayos, Maseches Brachos, Perek Aleph, Mishnah Dalet. So in the previous Mishnayos up until now, we've been talking about the time frame for saying the Shema, as well as how we should say it, whether standing, sitting, walking, etc. Today we're going to learn about the associated brachos with the night and the daytime Shema, or actually the daytime and the night Shema, according to the correct order of the Mishnah. So the Mishnah says, "B'shacham mevorik shtayim nefaneo v'achas l'achareo, uve'erev shtayim nefaneo u'shtayim l'achareo." So in the morning we have two brachas before and one bracha afterwards, or two before ayotzar and avarabba or avas oilam, depending on your nusach. And the one afterwards is emes v'yatziv. You know, the one we say emes v'yatziv and nokam v'kari yoyosha v'neman l'ohavu, when we try to say the whole bracha in one breath, or is that just me? I'm not sure. And then afterwards, we say, if for Ma'ariv, we have two before and two afterwards. The two before are Hamariv Aravim and Avas Oilam. And afterwards, we say Emes V'Amuna and Hashki Venu, which are a total of four in the evening and three in the morning, which is a total of seven. And as David HaMelech says, Sheva b'yom hilal ticha, seven in the day I will praise you. So that the Gemara says that this refers to the seven brachas of praise we say with regards to the Shema. Just as a side point now, that in the first Mishnah, we says, Me'ema say koirim, loshen rabim, and here we say mevarech, loshen yochid. So why is there a change in there? So says the Shinois Elio, he says that this is that is coming to teach us a halacha. What's this? That when we have people saying brachas with somebody else, that yochid can be moitzi the rabbim, that you can fulfill your obligation by hearing somebody else. But when it comes to saying the Shema itself, each and every one of us has got to say the Shema to fulfill our obligation. So now we're going to talk about achas arukah or achas katzara, whether it's a long one or a short one. There are lots of different interpretations of what long and short mean. There's Rambam, Rashi, Rashba, amongst others. Check it out for yourself. We're going to learn according to the pshat of the Rav, which is Rabbeinu Avadja Meir Bar Tanura. And he holds that Aruka and Katsara mean that Aruka is Baruch Atah Hashem at the start of a bracha and Baruch Atah Hashem at the end of a bracha. And Katsara is only having Baruch Atah Hashem at the end of the bracha and not at the beginning of the bracha. It has no correlation with regards to how many words are actually in the bracha or not. So we're going to learn according to the Bar Tanura. So, Mekoyim sh'aru l'harich, eino rashi l'katze, eino rashi l'harich. When Chazal gave us a long bracha with Baruch Atah Hashem at the start and the end, you're not allowed to be mekatze. And a short bracha without Baruch Atah Hashem at the beginning and only at the end, we're not allowed to make it longer by adding Baruch Atah Hashem at the beginning. I mean, if a doctor gave you a prescription for medication, you wouldn't decide just to take more than you meant to or not take as much as you meant to, because that would defeat the purpose. So to hear, Chazal gave us the exact prescription we need for the correct praise to Hashem for the bracha through Ruach HaKodesh, and we have got to stick to it. So when we have a bracha lachtoim, eino rashai shaloi lachtoim, if Chazal said at the end of a bracha you need to end it by saying Baruch Atah Hashem, you can't say, well, actually, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to take it. I'm not going to take this medication. For shaloi lachtoim, eino rashai lachtoim, that if there's not a Baruch Atah Hashem at the end, you're not allowed to add one in. For example, this is a category that we haven't seen yet. This is, for example, a bracha for tzitzis or for peiros, because we said Baruch Atah Hashem, Elokeinu Melech Haolam, Shalkoni Mevoroi, Borei Priyo Eitz, Al Mitzvah Tzitzis. Because the praise was so close to the Baruch Atah Hashem, and there's not a long gap in between the beginning of the bracha and the end of the bracha, so Chazal did not deem it necessary to add the Baruch Atah Hashem at the end to lachtoim with the Baruch Atah Hashem. So as long as we stick to the prescription of Chazal, then we'll be doing a great job. I hope you all have a wonderful week. You should grow, steig, all the brachas, all the yeshuas in the world, and keep safe. Kol tov.